Okay, today our project is putting in a plate display in this opening. So what I've done is purchased some oak. This is the oak we've purchased. We just got some project oak planking and a piece of oak veneered plywood. And then, like I said, we got some oak dowels, and which require me to drill several holes. So I bought a special bit that cuts in without splintering the wood. So we'll get busy building this plate rack. Okay, the first thing we got to do is go through and stain all the oak. I'm using a golden pecan stain to match the cabinets. It's a min wax rub on stain. So now we got all the dowels stained. What we'll do is put a coat of urethane on them. I've already done this piece here. You see it's got a nice gloss to it. Already been stained and urethane. So all our parts that we put that we're gonna cut and put together for this, we'll do the same thing to you. I'll actually build the box first so that I can glue it without having any of the urethane in between the glue joint. So once I get the box all cut and assembled, we'll stain it and urethane it, and then we'll start assembling all the dowels in it. Just thought I'd show this real quick. Here's a raw piece of oak, and then here's oak that's had the stain put on it. So kind of gives you an idea how much that changes the appearance of your wood by staining the oak. You know, a lot of people think oak cabinets are just natural with a urethane on them. They actually put a stain on them to change the tone of the oak. So like I said, I used a golden pecan to get my color. They have a golden oak stain, and it actually went way too dark to match my cabinets. So I tried about three different stains to come up with this one. Okay, we've got a little bit of stain on our top and our bottom pieces. We've actually taken and gotten these all drilled for our dowel rods. You'll see there's a countersink spot there for a number 6 screw. And we're going to start assembling the plate rack. That's actually the bottom, and this is the top. And what I did was clamped the rails together and drilled all the holes at one time, so they're all the same. And then I'm going to line it all up from one end so that all the slats or all the rods are nice and even, straight up and down. Okay, we got all the holes drilled, and we've got them all attached to our bottom and top. We've got the box assembled. Now we're working on cutting our dowels. Got about a third of them cut. Now I've stained and urethaned all those oak dowels prior to cutting. So right now we've just got our box is stained. It's not urethaned yet. I want to try to get all this preliminary fit up done before I put a coat of urethane on it. But hope we may even be able to get this thing installed tonight. I got a fast drying urethane. So I'll cut the rest of these dowels and see if we can't get this thing put together.
Some people would have cut all these dowels in one shot. The problem with that is you get a lot of splintering, And then also while you're making your cut, you want to really pull the saw in real slow so you let it cut and you don't rip these little dowels. Otherwise, they'll splinter real bad.
Okay, jump forward just a little bit. We've got the box all assembled. We got the back put on it. I brad nailed the back into it. So there is the plate rack in the cabinet. I kind of meant to catch video of the plate rack being assembled before I installed it, and then show the install after I got done. But there's a plate rack fully assembled. Now what I'm getting ready to do is put a 3-inch filler plate underneath the plate rack to finish out the whole system there. So I'll get a little video of that after I get it put in. Okay, I've got the filler panel in, the plate rack, so there's our upper cabinet assembly on the north wall. There it is with the filler rack. And so the top cabinets are all down on the north wall. And there's the plate rack Tracy wanted.